I mean, you can go to EW.com and read all the comments you want about people having an opinion, and they're all valid.
The following program.
Modern style.
I don't think we have the exact right answer on anything. We just have, we have to make a decision and we go with it. And I'm being very candid, as I always am with you. My first person I wanted on the show personally was Cerie. And I said, the audience still wants to see her win. And CBS said, first person we want is Ozzy. And I said, wow. And they said, how could you do a season called Game Changer without Ozzy? And I said, you're absolutely right. You're right. He's changed the game arguably as much as anybody. And that was how it went. And we just went back and forth. And we had the greatest time because we had 48 people we originally started with, and we ended up with 20. So that was a pretty fun process, and painful at times, to let people go and say, I'm not gonna win this one, you're not gonna win that one. And we ended up with 20 people that can take solace in the fact that everybody wants you to be here. Every producer on the beach is waiting to interview you. And we hope that the fans will trust us, that we're trying always to deliver a good show for you. We've been on a pretty good run. We hope you like Millennials versus Gen X. Give us a shot on this one.
Is there a limit to how many times someone can play Survivor?
No, I really don't think so. I think that would be foolish to say, yeah, five's the number. Because there is that idea of diminishing returns, but there's also the idea of maybe this is the time. It's like playing a lottery, you know. Maybe I'll win this week. Yeah, Jim, you've been playing for 27 years. You've spent the lottery trying to win the lottery. I know, but what if? It's always a question of what if.